Good afternoon. Welcome to my channel. I hope you're enjoying the videos that I'm making. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please go right ahead and do so and hit the bell button. Today, I'm getting ready to make a pizza. It's a keto-friendly pizza. It's my first time making this. So if I make mistakes, hey, at least I tried, right? So anyway, guys, with that said, let's get started. So here are the ingredients: almond flour, cream cheese, one egg, spaghetti sauce, marinara sauce. This is sugar-free. It's important to get sugar-free. Parmesan cheese, mozzarella cheese, and pepperoni. So we're gonna make a pepperoni cheese pizza, all right? We start off by adding one cup and a half of mozzarella cheese and 2 tablespoons of cream cheese into the bowl. Once you add them, make sure that you heat them up in the microwave, and I'll let you know why. So as you guys can see, I added the cheese already. That was 1.5 cups of mozzarella, 2 tablespoons of cream cheese, and now I have to do 2 tablespoons of mozzarella into the bowl. 2 tablespoons. All right, guys. And we're gonna microwave this for 50 seconds to 1 minute until it gets soft. Okay, so it's been 50 seconds. Now, as you can see, it's starting to get soft. Let me lower the music, I apologize. So, we just have to mix it. Make sure that it turns into like a little dough. So you gotta be making sure the consistency turns into like a dough. As you guys can see, it's getting soft. Microwave it for 50 seconds. So as you guys can see, you gotta do this for like 2 minutes so you can get that consistency, like a doughy kind of looking dough. This is what the video looks like, so I'm following the video. I actually put it on for an additional 20 seconds because it wasn't like soft enough. It depends on your microwave, how strong or how, you know, how good your microwave is. But there we go. See, now it's like doughy. Okay, and now we're gonna be adding the Parmesan cheese. The almond flour. Okay. We're gonna add the almond flour. It's 3/4 cup of almond flour. Here we go, this is the almond flour. We're gonna add it to the batter and we're gonna mix. We're gonna make sure the almond flour gets incorporated into this dough. Here you go. At this point, you can use your hand just to make sure that everything gets the almond flour and the rest of the stuff so it can get all mixed and it starts looking like a dough. See, as you guys can see, the consistency is becoming like a dough, but we have to And then we add our egg and we do the same thing with the egg. We combine everything. That's what the recipe says, so we'll see. We'll see how this comes out. It's my first time making a pizza, so I'm a little excited. And if your dough is sticky, like as you guys can see, it's a little sticky. Sometimes it comes out sticky. You can use extra almond flour. Let me wash my hand over here. You can add extra almond flour to the, right here, or to your counter or whatever. Just make sure you're washing your hands, you're cleaning your counters, and you're doing what you're supposed to be doing. So here we go. Maybe a little bit more, because we're gonna be kneading the dough here. Just until it's manageable and it's not sticky. Look at that. It's looking like a dough, huh? This is what I'm gonna have for dinner. Hopefully it comes out. Hopefully I'm able to do it, because sometimes, you know, I'm new at this. So this is my first time doing a keto pizza, actually making a pizza altogether. I never really make pizzas. I usually just cook Mexican food, but this is a change for me. So I am following recipes and stuff on YouTube. And this one's one recipe that I found. So I want to show it to you guys so you guys can do it. It's so easy. I mean, that's what she says. You know, I'm barely doing it. But as you can see the dough is getting manageable. So that's what you want. You want the dough to not be sticky, to be manageable. See? To be manageable. All right? So as you guys can see, the pizza kind of already started forming. And it's not as sticky anymore. So when that happens, let's move this. I'm going to use, because I don't have a pizza pan, you know, a pizza tray. I'm gonna use this little container to shape it. I got, this is for my fryer, for my, air fryer. So here we go. And we're gonna use this to shape our pizza, to shape it up. Shape it up, shape the pizza. I don't have a pizza tray, so I'm gonna do this instead. Usually with a pizza tray, you have more room, but I don't have a pizza tray, so I'm just gonna do this. There we go. See you guys? It's turning into a pizza now. Making a little crustier. It's a little personal pizza. There we go. Look at that. I'm just folding it up and making like a little crust. We'll see how it comes out, guys. So now you're gonna grab a fork and you're gonna make little holes, little, not crazy holes, but just little holes so that it doesn't have any bubbles when you're getting ready to cook this, because I'm gonna cook it right now. We're gonna cook this. Okay, make sure that you're doing this. So now we have our crust there. You know, I'm not an expert. I'm not the best at doing this. I think I didn't make sure there's holes. Okay. My first time, guys, so it kind of looks funny. But anyway, we're going to put it in the oven. The oven was preheating at 425. And we're going to throw it in there for about 10 to 15 minutes. Just keep looking at your oven, all right? Make sure you put your timer. Put it for 10 minutes, and then if it's ready, then we'll take it out. If it's not, we'll put it a little bit longer. Well, here is the crust, guys. I cooked it for about 12 minutes in the oven. Notice how it's already like all brown and everything. Now this is the time when we put the toppings in. Remember, the toppings is spaghetti sauce, 1 cup, but we can always estimate. Can do little by little. It's up to you. But if you want measurements, it's about a cup of marinara sauce. Or less. It's up to you. Whatever you want to put. I'm not a professional. I'm just doing the best I can. It's my first time making a pizza. I wanted to show you guys how to make one. So here we are. A little bit more. And look at that. Okay. Then we're gonna add the cheese. Oops. Little by little, so it can be everywhere. You can add more cheese, you can add less cheese, whatever you want to do. You're the one making this pizza. It's your pizza after all. You can do whatever you want with it. So there is that. And pepperonis. We got ourselves a keto-friendly, low-carb pizza that it's only taking us like 30 minutes to prepare. It's not that hard. It's very easy. It just takes, you know, motivation and wanting to do it. I just didn't want to be buying bad food, and I'd rather, you know, do this because this is healthy. It's less carbs, and we want to stay away from carbs and everything. So there we go. See, pizza. Okay, guys, so you have your pizza now. It's already made. And we're gonna put it in the oven for an extra 10 minutes so that it can all can cook. All right, so we're gonna wait and we'll come back. Well, as you guys can see, the pizza is cooked. I put it for about 8 minutes in the oven. I'm gonna slice it. 1 second. And we got pizza, guys. We got pizza. And there's lunch. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys enjoyed this recipe. Well, the pizza is made. It's already done. Look. So I'm gonna try it. It's my first time doing this, so please bear with me. So Father God, bless this pizza. Bless anybody else with no food right now. In Jesus' mighty name, amen, amen, amen. I'm gonna do one little slice. We're gonna do the testing. Okay. good. Mmm. Okay. Anyway, guys. Sorry. Yummy. Delicious. Anyway, guys, thank you for joining me. I hope you enjoyed this recipe. It's super simple, super easy. It's my first time making it. I'm super excited to start this journey with you guys. And I hope you guys come tonight. I have a Bible study every Wednesdays at 7 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. So please try to be here, okay? Take care. Bye-bye. I love you.